I went over there buy a house. I said, where that lady live at? And I went over there. I didn't even walk in the yard, you know, not disrespect, but I stood out there and said, shoot your best shot. If you can penetrate this blood of Jesus, so be it. But I slept real good and she couldn't do it. But they all found out that when the Lord blessed something, you can't curse what God blessed. You can't penetrate even the blood of bulls and goats. The death angel couldn't even come through them. What in the world he going to do with Jesus? And you keep that bloodline around you. You keep that bloodline around you. Because the devil can't penetrate it. Listen, y'all, he can whoop us. But he can't whoop Jesus. So we better be in faith with action and do what Jesus tells us to do so this stuff will work what he says.
That's it.
He's the victorious one, not us. We just get to get in on it. You better always remember that. Y'all follow me? Now, I gotta do what the Lord told me. Go to 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. And it's a little deep for some of y'all, but you know, just get the CD and listen at it 100 times and you'll get it. Because a lot of times we read these scriptures and don't have revelation, and I used to read them and didn't need it until he taught me, so I'm not condemning you. I'm called to get revelation and teach his people. And in the latter times, I mean, y'all know we in them times. Listen, some shall depart from the faith. What
do y'all think that means?
That they're going to depart from who Jesus is and what Jesus said. And believing that and doing what he said. Speaking what he said. Speaking what Jesus said. A lot of these ministers today, and I'm not naming nobody, but they don't even mention Jesus. They don't even mention the blood. And then some that do mention it tell you that once you get saved, that you don't even need faith no more. That God done did it all. But then if that's the case, then could nobody go to hell, because God has provided salvation for the whole world. But they you have to believe and accept that. But now when it comes to you living every day, you don't have to. You don't have to confess your sin. They done tried to take 1 John out chapter 1 out of the Bible and say they was wrong to sinners. I said, sinners? I said, man, ain't no way in the world I could have got saved with verse 9. I'd still be trying to remember anything I did wrong if I had to confess all my sins. I got to be in a place where I know what they are. And then John said, if we confess, he put him in there. And if he was talking to sinners, that means he needed to get saved too. It don't even make sense, man. It's doctrine of devils. In these latter times, people going to depart from who Jesus is and what Jesus did. Though they are believing and speaking and doing what Jesus said, they depart from faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And they'll speak lies and hypocrisy. They'll tell you, you're all right, when you have to live by faith, and the Bible says you have to endure to the end. You're not enduring to the end trying to live right to go to heaven. You're enduring to the end with your faith in Jesus. Amen. Hearing, speaking what he's saying, and doing it. Are you following me?
Yes.
And so, salvation is a gift, but it ain't a gift to live. Once you receive it, you got to do what he tells you. That's amen. And so you're being deceived by devils to make you think you can live in sin and you are all right. You're going to have a rude awakening when you die and go to hell and thought you was going to heaven. A lot of people are disappointed. They went to church here every Sunday and they're in hell right now. They wouldn't forgive. They dogged the pastor. They got a place in hell for homosexuals. Yeah. And then these preachers get on these shows with Oprah Winfrey and them and tell the world that homosexuals are going to heaven. Ain't no homosexual in the world going to heaven. Ain't no fornicator going.
That's
So I know ain't no homosexual going. Because if you ever get forgiven, you ain't none of that no more. So ain't no way in the world none of them going. Because once you're forgiven, you ain't that no more. And they telling them they going to heaven. Why? Because, listen now, doctrines of devils take you away from faith in Jesus. Hearing who he is, what he said, you saying what he said and doing what he tell you to do, they're coming to make you depart from this. Where you start speaking lies and hypocrisy. And your conscience becomes seared with a hot iron. Well, can't nobody even tell you, well, Jesus didn't teach that. Jesus didn't teach that. Let me show you faith again. Go to Luke chapter 17, verse 1 through 3. People departed. And the devil is, we gotta make that stop. Jesus said unto his disciples, it's impossible that offense will come. But woe unto him to whom they will come. It were better for him that a mouse go hung about his neck, and he cast in the sea, that he should offend one of these little ones. Take heed to yourself. If thy brother trespass against thee, rebuke him. If he repent, forgive him. Rebuke is just telling him he was wrong. And listen then. And if he trespass against thee seven times in a day, and seven times in a day turn again to thee, saying, I repent, thou shalt forgive him. The apostles, all the disciples said to Jesus, Lord, increase our faith. But here, now get the revelation, y'all. What was they needing increased? They could believe and speak and do what Jesus told them to do. They would tell, Lord, help us, increase us to be able to do this anytime somebody needs forgiveness. Are you beginning to see what faith is? It was hearing what Jesus said, putting it in their mouth, and doing it every time. Now my flesh ain't wanting to forgive everybody. I think people come to the same stuff. Pastor, I'm sorry. And your flesh said, but you just done that again. But they asked for forgiveness. It don't matter how my flesh feels. My faith in him has to forgive them. I am believing what he said, saying it out of my mouth, and doing it. It don't matter how I feel. Faith has nothing to do with how we feel. Nothing. And a lot of y'all in here, you still got some grudges against some folks. Exes and this here, they done this, and you still, how do you know, Pastor Scales? Because you still talk about it sometimes. When they name up, yeah, low down thing. Yeah, I remember. And I hear people, it just slips out of my mouth, and they then I say, well, you can unforgive. Oh, no, I forgive them years ago. No, you couldn't have said that. See, they think, they don't know, but your faith is exposed when you talk. Jesus said, out of the abundance of your heart, your mouth speak. You're lying if it came out of your mouth and you're saying you didn't mean that. When you have forgave, when the thought come up, you will resist that thought. And say, no, I done forgave him. And you will not voice that about them in an unforgiving way. You might voice it in a testimony to bring glory to God. But not in a way to still hold on to that in a negative way. Amen? And so we can see they ask the Lord to increase their faith. And Jesus, if you study it out and read the next few verses, he was telling him, look, it's your duty to do what I tell you to do. A servant don't go out in the field, come back from all the sheep and the cows, and come in and tell the master, let me sit down and eat with you first. No. When he come in, he got to fix the master something to eat and something to drink. And then when he get through feeding him and he get through eating, then he get to sit down and eat now. Jesus said, till you do what I say, See, you serve me first to believe and speak what I say. You can't sit down and eat yet. You don't get to rest yet till you get to doing what I tell you to do. People trying to rest and they ain't obeyed Jesus yet. Why? Go to Luke chapter 8, verse 22. People, listen, I'm teaching y'all. Don't settle for these people that they call superstars. I heard him say about this lady, she's a role model to young girls.
What?
See, they talking about ungodly. They don't say ungodly women. That she was a role model to all the heathen girls, but she wasn't a role model to Christian girls. And so what the devil want to do, y'all, is he want to exalt people that how they live, they in heaven. When they die, they in hell burning. Unless, before they die, they ask Jesus to forgive them. Because if you ask him to forgive you, you standing in the glory right now with him. Amen. It's some sins in the Bible in Revelation 21:8 that he say you ain't going to heaven if you do them. And if you've been forgiven of them, you ain't ever done. So if you're keeping repentance and you're hating that sin, I believe you go to heaven if you're keeping your faith in Jesus to get him to trust him to help you. Man, it's when you start living like that and you think you are. You done departed from the faith and don't even know it. The devil likes that. What is that? Luke 8, verse 22. Let me read you this. Jesus said to his disciples on a certain day that he went into a ship with his disciples. He said to them, let us go over to the other side of the lake. And they launched forth. But as they sailed, he fell asleep, and there came a storm of wind on the lake, and they were filled with water, and they were in jeopardy, and they came to him and awoke him, saying, Master, Master, we perish. Then Jesus arose and rebuked the wind and the raging of the water, and they ceased. And there was a calm. Now look at verse 25. Look what Jesus said to them. Where is your faith? Now what was their faith? Hearing what he said, believing it by speaking it out of their mouth, and then doing what Jesus wanted them to do. He said, where is that? Where's your faith in me? Now, the King James here is a little bland. And they being afraid, one to say and one to know, what manner of man is this? For he commanded even the winds and water, and they obey him. You got to believe that about Jesus. Everything obeys him. Every devil, every circumstance, every situation, if Jesus speak to it, it has to obey him. None on this earth has any protection toward Jesus. All your problems are bread for us. The biscuits. All your problems are biscuits. The bread. And you remember Caleb said, come on, y'all, let's go up at once in Numbers chapter 14, verse 8. And the Jews, they wanted to stone him and Joshua. And he said, come on, y'all. Come on. Let's not be afraid. They're bread to us. They've lost their defense. And in the Hebrew, they've lost their protection. And if you ever look at a piece of bread, and when you eat a piece of bread, it can't do nothing but just gobble down your mouth. A piece of bread don't have no defense from you eating it. It has no protection. A biscuit with some butter and jelly on it has no protection. If you want to gobble it up, it's nothing it can do. It has no defense. That's the same thing they were telling the children of Israel. They're bread to us. They have no protection. All your fears, all your troubles, all the devil can bring to you has no protection against Jesus. when Jesus says something to it, when you believe and speak what Jesus said to problems, they have no protection against Jesus. They have no defense. Jesus said, in the world you're going to have tribulation, frustration, testing, trials, but be of good cheer, I've overcome. They can't have no protection then. He said, cast all your care on me. They can't have no protection. They have no defense. Lack don't have no defense to the name of Jesus. Worry don't have no defense to the name of Jesus. Give me the Amplified Bible. Verse 25. Any of y'all got an Amplified Bible? Alright. Y'all read this with me. Make sure I'm reading right. And Jesus said to them, when he came up and rebuked the wind, why are you so fearful? Where is your faith? Now listen, the Amplified breaks down what your faith is. Your trust, your confidence in me, in my veracity. You know what that word veracity means? It means habitual truth, truthfulness. Jesus is an habitual truthfulness. He said, where was your confidence in me? Where was your trust in me? Where was your dependency on me? Where was your habitual knowing of my truthfulness when I tell you we're going to the other side? Why you didn't tell that storm where we going? Why you didn't tell your storm what I see? When trouble comes, Jesus said, you will not hurt me. When the devil comes, in the name of Jesus, loose my mind and loose my body. Take your hand off my money in Jesus' name. Where's your faith? I just don't know where we're going to get the money from. Where's your confidence in Jesus? Ooh. Where's your faith? Where's your confidence? Your habitual trust that he's trustworthy. What am I saying? Where's your faith? Your trust, your confidence in me, in my veracity and my integrity. And they were seized with alarm and profound and reverent dread. And they marveled, saying one to another, what then is this? And he commanded even the wind and the sea, and they obey him. And they still didn't understand what Jesus was saying right there. But they finally got it. And you can finally get it. When you quit being fearful and start having faith in him, confidence in him. He's perfect. He overcame. He's got the answers. He's got the wisdom. He knows how to do something. Let me tell y'all something. Sometimes, saints, you just need faith that Jesus knows what to do. You don't need no faith in nothing. You just need faith. He know what to do. Why? So you can seek him to get a word on what to do in your situation. And then when you get that word, you're going to have to speak that word. You believe it first, then you speak it, and then you do what he tell you to do. You're going to get results all the time in your life. And too many people don't know what to do. They trying to trust the Lord, and it ain't working. Can I show y'all in the scripture what he wants you to do? Look at James chapter 1, verse 2. Count it all joy when you fall. Joy. Joy. He wants me to have joy every time trouble comes. And you know probably 90% of y'all don't live this. Probably in the high 90s. That's the truth. I taught this years ago. More people do not get happy when trouble comes than Jesus know what to do. Your faith is he know what to do. That's your joy. Oh, the Lord know what should I know. I don't, but I know who do. That's joy. That's the only way you can have joy in every test and every trial. Is to know Jesus, know what to do. You can go ahead in the front of the test and get happy that the master knows what to do. He know how to make, He knew how to make bread and fish and multiply it at 12 past 11. He know how to make something be there that you can't see yet. He know how to not have a bone still get across the lake. Just walk across it. All the ships that left. So he didn't tell the watch that stand up. I created you. Stand up. And the watch said, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Everything say yes, sir, to Jesus. We got a champion that has passed into the heavens. Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast the confession of our faith in him. Let's talk about him some more. How great he is and what he accomplished when he was here on this earth. What did he accomplish? He accomplished being tempted by the devil and living perfect. Yes. Please God in every way. And took our sins away.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord taught me this. Listen to this, Pastor here. You probably know this, I'm sure, but the Lord taught me this to teach. I've been living in it for years. It's the three temptations, the devil. It's the greatest. He don't have no more. He did all of it with Jesus. Then 1 John 2:15, love not the world, neither things in the world. Any man love the world, love the false not him. The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. Ain't no more temptations. And then, do you know what them temptations are? All of them? You know what all of them connected to? Give me the Message Bible in 1 John 2:15. 16. Listen, do you know what all temptations that make all of us fail?